Donald Trump's civil fraud trial in New York has come to a dramatic end. First, there was a bomb threat at the home of the presiding judge. Then the former president, who's facing potentially hundreds of millions of dollars in fines, claimed it was he who should be compensated. Our US correspondent Catherine Firkin was there.
Off the campaign trail and in yet another courtroom. Donald Trump back in New York in a last-ditch bid to save his real estate empire.
They owe me damages for what they've done. We have a great company. We're a very innocent company. We did everything right.
The finale of his civil fraud trial as dramatic as its beginning, with Trump turning the courtroom into his stage. "This is a fraud on me. What's happened here, sir, is a fraud on me," he told the judge. "You can't listen for more than 1 minute. This has been a persecution." The outburst lasted a good 5 minutes before Judge Arthur Engoron cut him off and directed Trump's attorneys to control your client. Then, as the prosecution began delivering their closing remarks, Trump took off, opting instead to hold a press conference at a property on Wall Street.
"We've proven this case so conclusively. We've asked for directed verdict many times. They don't have any facts. They don't have any evidence against us."
Nonsense, according to the prosecution, which argued that the Trump Organization had deliberately inflated the values of its properties to win favorable loans with banks.
Security was a little heavier than usual outside the courthouse here in New York following a bomb threat made this morning at the judge's home. The incident comes just 4 days after a similar threat was made against a Washington, D.C. judge who's overseeing Trump's criminal election interference trial.
But while the former president has a busy schedule of ongoing trials, this one is effectively over. The Trump Organization has already been found liable for fraud. The question left is simply how much they'll have to pay in damages and whether Trump's real estate empire will be booted from the Big Apple. Catherine Firkin for 10 News First, New York.